We begin with a shocking scene at this hour, gunfire at a local synagogue. Let's get right to Chris Cannon now, live at the scene. Chris, what happened?
Vicki, we are at the West End Synagogue. That is about a half a mile west of 440 here on the West End area here. And take a look now. This is where Metro Police are investigating. Around 8:30 this morning, they say someone fired a shot here at this synagogue. And it is in that metal door frame there right behind that shrub that you see there. Now, around 8:30, a maintenance man was working on the side of the building, heard a loud noise, came around to see what was going on, inspected the building, and found that one bullet hole in the metal window frame here at the West End Synagogue. So far, no other sounds that were heard have contributed to this as well, but you can see Metro Police are still out here looking to see if there may possibly be any other shots that were fired. But again, if that loud noise that the maintenance man heard at 8:30 this morning is related to that, that is what police believe happened here at the West End Synagogue. Again, this just happened a short time ago. Metro Police are still on the scene investigating to see what happened. We'll, of course, bring in the latest starting at 4 o'clock, and of course, we'll break any new details online. Live on West End, Chris Cannon, News Channel 5 HD.
Thanks so much, Chris. At least one person is dead and a community college in North Carolina, and the campus is on lockdown at this hour. This is in Goldsboro, North Carolina, at the Wayne County Community College. At last word, authorities said the shooter is not in custody. Back here, two young children are recovering after being hit by a car while playing in the street. The two children were inside a large cardboard box on the side of Turner Lane yesterday morning in Clarksville. The driver did not stop, and the two children were taken by Lifelike to the hospital.
There's a lot of blame to go around, but I don't believe that the driver was without blame. I'm a little bit upset, but I don't blame him solely.
Police later found the driver and questioned them. Police say right now they don't think the driver realized that children were even there. And on a happier note, congratulations to Tennessee's own Justin Timberlake. It's a boy. JT's wife, Jessica Biel, gave birth to the couple's first child, Silas. The notoriously private couple announced the pregnancy back in January with an Instagram post where he kissed her belly. How cute is that?